It was awful scenery. The house was burning in front of them. Was it an accident? No, it was surely an attempt to burn it. Some people must have planned to burn the Prime Minister's house. It was a bad reputation for the security issue, though. Who might want to kill the Prime Minister? It was a big fault of the security. The fire brigade and all the firefighters were there to put out the burning cottage. The military and all the police cars arrived as soon as they heard the alarm. All the reporters from all television channels arrived. They were all trying to make themselves a space to announce this breaking news next to the security line. It was like a daytime with their lights, even though it was 2 o'clock in the morning. The cottage was far beyond the nearest city. It was in a nice touristy area near the lake. Prime Minister came here twice a year with his family to spend his short vacation. One person said,
"It's like a hell."
Another person said,
"Oh my God, I hope no one was hurt."
Suddenly, they heard a scream. It was the sound of a dog. It was Prime Minister's dog. It was running through Anne, the daughter of the Prime Minister. She caught the dog and held it in her arms with tears. But she was so happy that it was alive.
"Oh, Tiki, you are here,"
said Anne. Her mother, the first lady, was called by the security. Anne also followed her mother. The Prime Minister should have been taken somewhere else.
"Why do people want to kill us?"
asked Anne to her mother. Her mother put Anne's head on her shoulder and kept her silent. They were in a big van, which belonged to the army. In the van, there were also guards of the First Lady and Anne. They were talking on their radios and transmitting messages. Also, they were making Anne and her mother calm down.
"Where is Dad, Mom? Is he okay?"
asked Anne.
"Yes, sweetie, he is all right. He will be with us very soon," said her mother.
"Okay, young lady. Well, we are very special electives. We are here to protect you, but we need some information. We will find out who set the fire. We will solve it very soon,"
said Carl with a warm smile. All the people were working in groups. In each group, there were aristocrats and connoisseurs. They all gathered in the meeting room. They seemed very hectic in the meeting room. When the Prime Minister arrived, they all became silent. He wasn't hurt by the fire in his cottage. He made a very short speech and let Jack give orders. Jack was a middle-aged man, but he was so good at his job that he got the promotion to become a high-level agent 2 months ago. This case could crack his profile within the organization if he failed. He collected all the reports that the other agents gave and gave new orders to his staff. It was always difficult for him to work within aristocrats. It was a new rule to work with one of them at least. The First Lady and Anne were sleeping in the van when it stopped.
"Where are we?"
said the First Lady to her guard. But her guard wasn't there. She saw that there was only she and Anne in the van.
"You are my guest, my lady. I hope you will like my hospitality. You will have to stay in my humble place, whether you like it or not,"
said the driver who was wearing a mask. Anne woke up and her ducks started to bark.
"What's going on, Ma? Where are we? Aren't we coming home?"
The First Lady understood that they were kidnapped. It was a trap. The fire of the house and all chaos were just for the security to be distracted. They were in the middle of nowhere, and they could see was forest.
"Anne, darling, please pretend to be a young woman. We aren't from. We were taken here. Your dad doesn't know that we are here, but I am sure he will find us very soon,"
said the First Lady.
"Are we kidnapped?"
"Yes, Anne, it's time you behave like a Prime Minister's daughter."
Carl and the other guards weren't with them. They were blindfolded and walked into bushes. They walked about half of a kilometer when they finally arrived at a cottage. Anne was so scared. It wasn't too long for Jack to understand the First Lady and Anne were kidnapped. It was his mission to tell the Prime Minister this unfortunate news.
"What? Was a trap? You should find my wife and my daughter alive as soon as possible. If they want to negotiate, please do what they say."
It was 5 o'clock in the morning. The sun was about to rise. Jack had a call from the kidnappers.
Jack, young agent, becomes a high-level detective in the country. What made you such a connoisseur? I know all about you, Jack. You and your wife were in love until last year, but somehow the debates grew and you divorced. I know you still love your life,
said the man.
Who are you? How do you know so much about me? Where are the first lady and I?
Oh, Jack, you are in a panic. Calm down. I have two nice home for the breakfast this morning. I will enjoy my breakfast with them, but you will not eat anything though today because you have lots of things to do.
Who are you? What do you want?
I want to remain.
He hanged up the phone just as they were trying to find his location, but they couldn't find it. What did he mean with revenge? How did he know so much about Jack? He was not like terrorists. All terrorists want some kind of freedom and money. But this guy didn't want anything but revenge. Why? How? Who? All these questions were chasing each other in his mind when Julia said something excitedly, but he didn't hear. Sir, I said the dog. Tiki has a GPS in his collar. If Tiki the dog is with them, we can find them very soon.
Julia, this is so great. With the GPS we can identify where they are. I love technology. Let's go and track where they are. Hey Dave, please research in all the past 20 years and find out all the kidnapped cases, especially wives and children.
Immediately, sir.
It was around 8 o'clock and Anne and her mother were staying with their hands tied in a dark room in the cottage. Tiki was with them. They heard some voices coming from the other room. Tiki started to bark again. Suddenly, the door opened.
All right. Breakfast is ready, my ladies. If this dog doesn't shut up, I will need to kill him. Excuse my language. I can't be always polite like you, aristocrats,
said the masked man. But Tiki never stopped barking. He hated the man, but he never understood that he would be dead if he continued barking. He put the breakfast tray on the table.
All right, I have no other choice. I used to have a dog when I was a child. One day, he left and never came back. Since then, I have never had a dog.
Please, don't kill him. He's my dog. I will make him calm down,
said Anne.
You had better do that, little lady.
In the intelligence room of the organization, Jack was with his officers.
It is too weird that the signals are there, sir.
What does it mean? Does it mean the dog is dead?
No, sir. If the dog is dead, the device still works. But it might be some kind of frequency that jeopardizes the GPS signal.
Can we find out where the dog went until the signals were dead?
Yes, we can. I can see that the dog was in the cottage, which was burnt last night. Then the head is to the north of the country where the nuclear plant was located. It is in the forest area.
Then Julia said, you'll get a phone call, sir. It is Carrie, your ex-wife.
Please tell her that I will call her later.
I have already told her, but she insists to talk with you.
Sir, we are the kidnapped prisoners who are the last 20 years. But I have found out that there was an incident 5 years ago which made me very suspicious.
Said they.
What is it?
Asked Jack.
There was an agent named Mark Williams who served for the country with lots of awards. He is retired now. His wife and his son were kidnapped by the terrorists when he was at work. They were kidnapped when he was in Kenya for a mission. Then he went near their bodies when he came back. The thing is that the Prime Minister was then the chief of the police department. He couldn't do anything to save his wife and his son.
Now I want you to find where Mark Williams is.
Julia was still looking at Jack. Carrie says she can understand. Jack did not have any time to think about Carrie. He threw, if they were near the nuclear plant, he might have a worse plan. All the helicopters and police vehicle headed to the nuclear plant. They made a big circle around the area. Jack was in one of the helicopters and talking with other team members. Then he got a call from Dave.
Sir, I have found out Mark Williams' address. We are here in his house. It is very strange that I have found the hospital report. He has a cancer. He has nothing else to lose. He is more dangerous than the other attackers.
Thank you, Dave. You did a great job.
All of the team surrounded the area. Finally, they arrived at the nuclear plant. The staff was doing their daily routines until they saw all the agents in front of them.
You know what? I get a feeling, Doc. He's going to die anyway with us.
No, we don't die. My father will find us.
And screams.
Your father is incapable of finding innocent women and children. You know what? If we are all going to die, I will not need to wear this mask.
He took off his mask. He was about his late 40s. He could have been a good man with an expression in his face. But the desire of taking his revenge let him go this way. A few minutes later, they found a bomb in the plant. They evacuated the building and experts arrived to stop it.
Sir, the bomb works with a remote control. Let's see what we can do here.
Alright, Bob, be careful.
Said Jack when he was on the ground where they were chasing the track of the footsteps in the forest.
I'm not afraid of you, said Anne.
You should be, but you are a very brave girl.
Suddenly the door opened.
Okay, that's it, Mark. The guy is surrounded by hundreds of agents,
said Jack.
No, it isn't all over. I lost my family when I was at work, but nobody cared. But I did. Now, it's time everybody had the same feeling, not only the Prime Minister,
said Mark.
I know your pain, but this is not the way. I lost my family because I worked a lot. I couldn't spend enough time with my wife either,
said Jack. Mark was holding a little device in his hand and raised his hand and said,
if I push this button before you shoot me, everybody will die. You know that I'm so fast. Push the button, Jack. You were a little kid when I was an officer in the organization.
Suddenly, Tiki started to bark again. He dropped the device on the floor with that sound. Then all the agents captured him and released the First Lady and Anne. Then the bomb at the nuclear plant became ineffective. He was awarded by the Prime Minister at the government house. All the reporters were there. He was surrounded by tens of cameras and reporters to give a speech. When he was giving his report, he saw Carrie looking at him across the street.
What I learned from the case was that spend your time with your family as much as you can,
said Jack before he made a way among the people across the street.